Ladies and gentlemen, we have a blockbuster trade in the NBA, and unfortunately, though, however, the Sixers weren't involved in it, but they were in the talks with it. James Harden is now a member of the Brooklyn Nets in a four-way trade. Yes, an absolute blockbuster trade. We're going to talk about this and discuss what does this mean for the Sixers. Don't go anywhere. Let's get this started. To my channel, it is your boy El Parcero Philly, nutter of all things sports and culture here in the beautiful city of Philadelphia. Before we move forward, ladies and gentlemen, do not forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell button for notifications, as well as sharing this video and this channel to help your favorite Parcero grow here in this beautiful city. Now look, I found myself in 2020, 2021, actually becoming a fan again of the NBA. I'm getting more and more intrigued with this league. Obviously, their stance on Black Lives Matter really attracts me, so I've been really getting into it. But you know, I don't wanna make this channel about NBA content, but this is a trade that we do need to discuss because we were in the running for the James Harden sweepstakes, and this kind of changes, not really, but it really enhances Brooklyn's chances of winning the Eastern Conference. But I'm gonna tell you why I'm not too worried about Brooklyn in the Eastern Conference playoffs when we get there. But let's just talk about the trade, what it means for Brooklyn, and we'll talk about how that affects the Philadelphia 76ers. So the trade is, obviously, the Nets get James Harden. Four teams involved. Nets, Rockets, Pacers, and the Cavs. The Rockets do get Victor Oladipo, Radonis Krukis, I'm butchering that name, Dante Exum, the former first-round draft pick, four unprotected first-round picks, Brooklyn's 2022, 2024, 2026, Milwaukee's 2022, and four unprotected first-round swaps, 2021, 2023, 2025, and 2027. So, obviously, Houston is taking a page out of Sam Hinkie and Sam Presti's book and trying to collect some serious assets because they're really getting them. I think that's kind of what hindered the Sixers in getting James Harden. We don't have too many assets over the years. We kind of got rid of those things, so they really were looking for those. Obviously, the Nets get James Harden. That's really the meat of the trade. The Pacers, however, I really think they got a solid piece of this trade here. So they get Caris LeVert, who I think really high of. If you did watch my Sixers review after the Brooklyn game, yeah, I'm really high on Caris LeVert. Got this in my turtleneck. Don't even know what that is. They get a 2023 second round pick from Houston, and then the Cavs get Jared Allen and Taurean Prince. Kind of questioning that move. Obviously, Jared Allen is strictly a center. They already have Andre Drummond. So I would assume that one of those two are leaving, or they are just, you know, they're just going back to full tank mode and are going to play two centers in that lineup. But I don't really get it. Taurean Prince, obviously a good solid role player. It's tough to say. So when it comes to James Harden, obviously Brooklyn has a really lethal big three on paper with Kyrie Irving, James Harden, and Kevin Durant. To be completely honest with you guys, the reason why I'm not like going so crazy like some people are over this big three, it's because, again, like I constantly keep repeating myself, I always take character over skill any day of the week. Obviously, these three players have really good skill. These are probably top 10 players in the NBA, all three of these guys. And they should be favorites throughout going forward in the season. But James Harden, we just saw what went down in Houston. And I don't know how that gives you guys any vote of confidence. I get what he does on the court, but what are you trying to do? You trying to be the best regular season team, or are you trying to win a finals here? And just some of the relationships that he kind of just like burned under the bridge in Houston, even this season. DeMarcus Cousins, I just heard his press conference talking about the situation. He felt disrespected, and as the whole Rockets organization should feel disrespected. James did not feel that the Rockets gave him enough to work with in order to win this season. It's kind of a James, it's kind of a shot at your teammates. He didn't feel confident in John Wall, even though they were buddies in the past. And even the past couple years, like, Houston has given him stars to work with. Russell Westbrook, Chris Paul. I know Patrick Beverley's not a star point guard, but that guy is a damn well defender. He played with him, Jeremy Lin, Dwight Howard. He's worked with a bunch of different stars, and it always ends bad. It just does. He's one of the most talented players in the NBA, but as a teammate, I question him. And I think that's more important to me than the skill set that he demonstrates. Yeah, he's going to put up 40 points tonight, but he's not going to play defense, and he's probably not going to carry anyone. And I know it's going to work here in Brooklyn because you already have veteran stars like Kyrie and Kevin Durant, but that's kind of an issue. But let's also talk about Kyrie Irving, because who the hell knows what that guy wants to do? Obviously, last Thursday against the Sixers, he last second pulled out of the lineup, pulled out of the game, and hasn't played since. And we don't really know why exactly he doesn't want to play. And it is what it is. It's his business. You know, it's not really our business to determine why it is he didn't want to play. But when Steve Nash is coming right before the game saying, "I don't know what's going on with Kyrie Irving," there's a problem there. There's a serious problem there. And I mean, Kevin Durant, you guys know I love Kevin Durant. I'm never going to slander Kevin Durant. He is the part owner of the union, so I will never slander Kevin Durant on this channel. But still, I'm not full on board with Brooklyn going all the way, running the table, and winning the East. Not just as a Sixers fan, but as in general. It literally just takes one bad day, one bad action, one bad thing to happen for James Harden or Kyrie Irving to blow up, and the Brooklyn season's over. And obviously, people want to compare this trade to what Brooklyn did a couple years, like, what was it, 6 years ago now? Oh, Billy King trading away all those first-round draft picks. Boston created a dynasty. Oh, well, not dynasty, but created a solid team. And then for turn, they get Kevin Durant or Kevin Garnett, Paul Pierce, Jason Terry. And that lasted like a season. But this is different because Brooklyn is getting a superstar right now. They already have two other superstars, so that's definitely different. But still, they definitely did give up a lot of draft picks after it seems like they got them all back after that Boston trade. But the Rockets, obviously, Oladipo. What is the future for Oladipo? Honestly, he's on the last year of his deal, and from what it looks like, I feel like Houston is just trying to blow up and tank. But I think that they have a solid lineup right now. You know, you still got John Wall. Obviously Oladipo gets thrusted into the lineup. You still got Boogie, PJ Tucker. So there's a couple of pieces in Houston. So I don't think they'll make the playoffs or whatnot. I still think that the bottom half of the West is still really tough. But Houston's definitely planning for the future. The Pacers get Caris LeVert. I love that. I absolutely love that for the Pacers. You already got Malcolm Brogdon, and you also have Domantas Sabonis. And obviously, TJ Warren went off last season, we all remember. He's been quiet this year, but I love Caris LeVert. He's a really good scorer, and he's still young. Still think his best years of basketball are ahead of him. Indiana's trying to be that tricky team. Obviously, they finished in fifth in the East last year. But this move here, I really think it's going to be an upgrade from Oladipo, quite honest with you. And then obviously, we just talked about the Cavs. Don't get why Jared Allen left. And Jared Allen for Brooklyn, you guys realize that's what stopped Joel Embiid, right? Like, he is the only thing I really think that could slow down Joel Embiid. I'll be interested to see how they try to slow him down in the next matchup. But I thought that was a loss for Brooklyn. But overall, obviously the Nets wanted to do this, especially not knowing what's going on with Kyrie, and Kevin Durant wanted to team up again with James Harden. He understands, you know, having multiple star players does help. He just came from Golden State. But I'm not as high on Brooklyn as some are. So what does this mean for the Sixers? This is what we're here for, right? The Sixers were in talks, and it seemed as if it was between the Sixers and the Nets to get James Harden. And what really took this deal so long was the fact that I feel like Daryl Morey and the Sixers were not trying to throw in Ben Simmons. They were trying to make a trade that wouldn't require throwing Ben Simmons in. And that's when Brooklyn stepped in and it was a better deal that was given to Houston, and Houston ran with that deal instead of going for whatever they were trying. I'm assuming that Tyrese Maxey and Matisse Thybulle were thrown into that offer, but that's just assumptions. I don't really know. We don't really have a report yet. But look, and I talked about it even after last night's game. Ben Simmons needs to step up big time. And I know we keep talking about his inability to score, but if Ben Simmons can score, we are going to be okay. But I don't have any confidence that he's going to do that. And I feel like Sixers Nation are in the same boat. Now, I didn't want James Harden, and I just explained to you why. I don't think that was good for the locker room that we had, or we have right now. But there's still other options out there. I mean, Bradley Beal, the Wizards suck, and they're going to keep getting bad. So the Wizards are going to be on the clock. And the problem is that you're probably going to have to put together a bigger package than what you offered Houston to get Bradley Beal. Because Bradley Beal, in my opinion, and I think most people would agree, is a, right now, better player to trade for than James Harden. James is obviously a little older, and he comes with baggage, even though he's probably he is a better scorer than Bradley Beal. But obviously Bradley is more of a team player, and he's trying everything he can to win in Washington, but they're just not that good, and it's really unfortunate. Obviously Zach LaVine's not pushing any needle, but it'll definitely be a smaller package to throw at Chicago than what you would have to throw at Washington in order to get that player. So I'm on board. We're trying to get some scoring help here in Philadelphia, because as you clearly tell, Brooklyn's not playing any games this year, and we still have Boston, we still have Milwaukee. Those guys can score. Milwaukee's been really efficient this year as a shooting team. So I'm not here sitting saying that we need to trade Ben Simmons. Like, we need to do it. Like, I'm not saying that, but I'm at a point now where with Ben Simmons where if a team comes offers something that would help us, improve us, then yeah, I'm okay with parting away with Ben Simmons. As much of a Ben Simmons fan I am, I'll be down for it. So, big day in the NBA. Obviously, Woj probably being really busy today as he is the famous Woj bomb. But this really does change a little bit here in the Eastern Conference. And Brooklyn's still the favorite. But now everyone has them as the NBA final favorite. So that is the difference. But that's all I got for you guys today. In the comments below, again, let's continue the conversation. Let me know what your thoughts were on this James Harden deal. What do you think the Sixers need to do to improve upon? Because look, I know we're solid right now, we're 8-3, but look, Brooklyn has a serious team going on right now. So let me know what you guys think. Do not forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell button for notifications, as well as sharing this video and this channel to help your favorite Parcero grow. And until next time, ladies and gentlemen, I go by the name of Ed Parcero Philly, and I'm telling you guys, the truth, the damn process. Talk to you soon.